Hi all, welcome to today's session. Today we are going to discuss about a thyristor called TRIAC. TRIAC is a bidirectional thyristor, that is, it can conduct in both the directions. TRIAC is basically a 5-layer 3-terminal semiconductor device. Here we are using two SERs which are connected in an inverse parallel manner on the same chip. TRIAC is basically termed to be triode for alternating current. That is, it only functions as a 2 inverse parallel SER for AC. It is not designed to work for DC. TRIAC of maximum rating of about 16 kilowatt is even available. Now, let's see the construction of TRIAC. Here, you can see that there are 2 SERs which are connected in an inverse parallel manner. There are 3 terminals for a TRIAC, that is NT1, main terminal 1, main terminal 2, NT2, and G, the gate term. The gate is a common terminal connected to both the SERs and it is connected to the N and P regions of either SER. Let's see it in detail. This is the construction of a TRIAC. We have 2 SERs which are connected in an inverse parallel manner. And we can see that the main terminal 2 and main terminal 1 have been taken and gate is connected common to both the SERs from P and N regions of either SERs. So, the advantage of it is that we can give the control signal to either of the SER, making it a bidirectional thyristor. This is the 2 thyristor analogy of TRIAC and this is the corresponding circuit symbol. Now, let's see the working of TRIAC. TRIAC mainly work under 4 modes of operation. Those 4 modes have been depicted in this graph. Quadrant 1 shows mode 1, quadrant 2 shows mode 2, quadrant 4 refers to mode 3 and quadrant 3 refers to mode 4. Let's see these 4 modes in detail. When you consider the 4 modes of operation, the first one, that is mode 1, that is when NT2 and gate being positive with respect to NT1. And the second mode is when NT2 is negative and gate is positive with respect to NT1. Here in the mode 1, we can see that NT2 and gate both are positive with respect to NT1. The SER1 will conduct and the current will flow from NT2 to NT1. In the second mode, mode 2, NT2 is negative and gate is positive. During this mode, the SER2 will conduct and the current will flow from NT1 to NT2. In the third mode, mode 3, NT2 is positive and gate is negative with respect to SER. Here again, SER1 will conduct, then the current flows from NT2 to NT1. And in the mode 4, NT2 and gate both are negative with respect to NT1. During this mode, SER2 will conduct and again the current will flow from NT2 to NT1. Even though it has got 4 modes of operation, we prefer to have mode 1 and mode 4, and that is considered to be the most efficient mode comparing to the other 2. And these 2 modes, because of the same reason, is termed to be the normal modes of operation. Now, let's analyze the VI characteristic curve of TRIAC. As I already told you, we prefer the mode 1 and mode 4, that is the normal modes of TRIAC operation, and that is what is analyzed in the VI CARA curve. Quadrant 1 corresponds to the mode 1 operation, that is when NT2 is positive, that is SER1 will conduct. During that time, what happens is that the TRIAC will be in the off position until it reaches the breakover voltage, and when it exceeds the breakover voltage, the voltage drop decreases to a low value and thereafter the TRIAC will conduct. And the current corresponding to the value where the TRIAC conducts is termed to be the holding current. And you can see that a similar operation is taking place in quadrant 3, where mode 4 operation is taking place. Here also, what happens is that the NT2 will be made negative with respect to NT1, then SER2 will be in the conducting state. Again, on a similar value of breakover voltage, the TRIAC will conduct, start conducting, and the corresponding holding current is also given. So, we can see that the TRIAC operation is somewhat similar to that of SER. the graphical shape is identical to that of SCR, and in mode 1 and mode 4 it is symmetrical also. So that is about the characteristics of SCR. And we can have our control over the breakover voltage. That is, as we increase the gate current applied to the gate terminal, we can decrease the breakover voltage and track can be conducted soon. Now, these are some of the parameters related to TRIAC. These are some of the rating values given in the specification sheet of TRIAC. First one, latching current. After the TRIAC is being turned on, in order to remain that TRIAC in the conduction state itself, the amount of TRIAC current to be given, that is what is termed to be latching current. Similarly, holding current, it is the amount of main terminal current required so that it can remain in the conduction state itself. So these two current are specified after the TRIAC is being turned on. After the TRIAC is turned on, in order to remain in condition in the conduction state itself, the amount of TRIAC gate required is the latching current, and the amount of main terminal current required is the holding current. The third one is gate trigger current. That is the current given to the gate value so that it got triggered. That is, it is going to the conduction state initially. The fourth one is main terminal RMS current rating. It is the value above which the TRIAC can control. Next is the main terminal RMS current rating. It is the maximum amount of current that a TRIAC can withstand. That is, above the rating value, the device will get damaged. Now, let's discuss some of the merits of the TRIAC, rather the advantages of TRIAC. As I already told you, since this is a bidirectional thyristor, it can be triggered with both positive and negative gate pulses. And another advantage is that it requires only one heat sink, unlike the SCR, because SCR requires two heat sinks of smaller sizes, but in TRIAC it requires only one heat sink with a larger size. And another advantage is that it requires only single fuse for its protection, and it has got a safe breakdown in either directions. And when you consider the demerits, we can see that the gate current sensitivity is very poorer. It requires a well-designed RCS number so that the protection is given. And since the minority carrier storage effect is happening, the turn-off time will be much longer. Finally, let's discuss some of the applications of TRIAC. TRIAC has got wide range of applications since it can be conducted in both the directions. And we can see that it can be used in many control circuits, like in heating control, in motor speed control, in power control, in light dimming circuits, and in high power lamp switching. So that's all for today. Thank you.